okay, how long are you going to be standing there, down there, spinning around like that, slowly, over and over? I don't know what you want from me. I don't get it. You've been here all day. You've just been sitting there doing nothing. What do you want?
Just want to be in one video. That's all.
I know, Blue. I know you want to come back. But I don't need you guys anymore. I'm sorry. I don't need spinny logos, watermark logos in my reviews anymore.
Needed us back then, man. What is this burger shit you're feeding us?
Well, yeah, I need you back then, Red. But you know what? I don't need more. I mean, kid, it's getting ridiculous. You've been here all day, and all you want to do is just sit there and spin around and hoping I would have you guys in a video.
Just miss being in your videos is all, dude. That's all it is.
Well, Blue, I understand, but you know, I don't need you anymore, okay?
Burgerly asshole, how could you even say that to us?
Watch it, Red. You're on thin ice as it is. You better watch it. And you know what? After that comment, you both skedaddle. Scoot, get out now.
My word, we will be back.
Hello, everybody. Sorry to be up about that. Two little watermarks want to come out of retirement, but I told them I don't need them anymore. But I told them to scoot, and hopefully that's the last we see of them. I'm sorry about that, people. But welcome back to my Time Crisis Remastered series review, episode 2, and we're on part 4 of 6. And I should mention, I'm going to take a look at Time Crisis Crisis Zone, because I figured since we're in the Time Crisis mood here, it's time to get, I might as well do it too, because it's considered a Time Crisis, this game, and spin-off and all that stuff. And we're going to be continuing the PlayStation 2 era of the Time Crisis franchise here. We got our GunCon 2, which is used for this as well. But we have a lot to talk about here, but before we get started, here's a hot and fresh, out of the oven TTBurger recap, hot and fresh like a cheeseburger that's ready to have for dinner, show you all what you missed. In the last part, I took a look at Time Crisis 2 for the PlayStation 2 and gave it a 9 out of 10 because it was a great sequel overall and improved a lot from the original Time Crisis and definitely improved over Time Crisis Project Titan. But there were a couple things it improved on, so I gave it a 9 out of 10 because it was the best score I can give it there, definitely. And now we're going to zoom ahead to the year 2003, October 21st, 2003, which was my 15th birthday, actually. So this game came out on my 15th birthday, so happy birthday day to me there, and the same day with the Castlevania Lament of Innocence released in North America as well. This game was first released in the arcades on September 16th, 2002, and then like about a year later, we got it for the PlayStation 2 here. This is Time Crisis 3 for the PlayStation 2. And it came with another GunCon control here. Like, those of you who got the GunCon 2 for PlayStation, for Time Crisis 2, I mean, the same one comes with Time Crisis 3, so you wouldn't be missing on anything there. You still get that nice orange color there. So yeah, that's what it is there. Now, with Time Crisis 3, I had high hopes for this game because this game added a lot of new gameplay features to it and stuff, and it'll definitely be worth talking about for sure. And I'll say this right now, Time Crisis 3 is the best game in the Time Crisis franchise! Woohoo! Yeah! Because this game is fucking awesome, it took everything great about Time Crisis 2 and made them even better. Made them even better and make it the best game in the franchise for sure. Time Crisis 3 once again uses the GunCon controller, like same color as before, so no changes there. And Time Crisis 3 adds a new feature where you can use different weapons other than your handgun to use throughout the game. You can use a machine gun, a shotgun, a grenade gun, and more, adding more challenge and fun to the game for sure, but I'll talk about that later. The story of Time Crisis 3 actually has two stories that merge together. The arcade story and the rescue mission story. The game takes place 6 years after Time Crisis 2 on a Mediterranean Astigos of the nation called Lucano. Lucano is in trouble because of the Zagorian Federation Army. The Lucano Liberation Army has been trying to stop them after they learned that they distributed tactical missiles on Astigos Island, and they must be stopped because it will be fatal for Lucano. Two BSSE agents, Alan Dunaway and Wesley Lambert, are sent to put an end to this threat to Lucano and take out their leader, Giorgio Zahn. And unknown to them, Wild Dog is involved as well with his new partner, Wild Fang. They are joined by Alicia Winston, who is on a mission of her own while helping the two agents. In the rescue mission story, Alicia's trying to rescue her older brother Daniel Winston, the leader of the Lucana Liberation Army. When she learns he has been kidnapped by the Ligoyas Federation Army along with Jake Hernandez, who is second in command. This story is exclusive to the home version of the game, and it shows the true ending of the game as well. And interesting enough, in my opinion, I consider Alicia the main protagonist of the game because it shows the true ending of the Rescuation story and what really happened afterwards. I'll talk more about this later, but the story is fucking excellent, fucking amazing. It is a little bit longer, still is a little short, for sure, but fucking fantastic, whatever you want to call it, but it still works. Presentation of Time Crisis 3? It's the best looking Time Crisis game ever. Great character models that animate better than it did in Time Crisis 2. The cutscenes are pre-rendered and look fantastic as well. The endgame graphics are good, but some of the character models look kind of blocky and bland when you see like some of the enemies up close look kind of bland in their faces and everything. But you have great colorful backgrounds and once again a smooth frame rate. The sound has crisp voice acting. Alicia, who is voiced by Melissa Hutchins, steals the show for the voice acting. The other actors sound great too, not as hammy as they were in the last couple games and before that, but still the voice acting is fantastic for sure. Music is the same style of song and dance as before, but it still feels like it's the best out of the bunch. Just something about it just feels the best out of the bunch. The gameplay of Time Crisis 3 is the best part, and it's fucking improved from the last game for sure. You get a bunch of new modes of time, including the rescue mission mode, which is the best part of Time Crisis 3 in my opinion. Like I mentioned, this is once again a light gun game, just like Time Crisis 2, but better. You have a bunch of new weapons in this game, they are a big help, like I mentioned the machine gun, the shotgun, and the grenade gun. They do not have unlimited ammo, so use them wisely, but that's the thing there. It adds a challenge to it for sure. You can get more ammo when you run out by taking out the enemies in yellow. The arcade story mode is simple. Shoot your way to the end, either playing as Alan Dunaway or Wesley Lee Lambert. Player 1 as Alan and player 2 as Wesley. And the challenge factor in here is great. The rescue mission, which is exclusive to the PlayStation 2, puts you in the role of Alicia Winston, and you just do the same thing for the most part with some changes here. First, your weapons can be upgraded by the amount of the enemies you kill and adds more of the fun factors to it. Like, it makes it more powerful and gives you more ammo for them that I can hold. And there are parts in the game where you can use a sniper rifle to take out the enemies as well, which adds a fun factor to it as well. You can basically shoot them while aiming with your sniper scope and more. I will admit here, the rescue mission is hard. And it's due to the fact that once you lose all your lives, you go back to the beginning of the stage. Which is weird because the arcade story mode lets you start where right after you left off when you died and stuff, but here it doesn't. And it can get pretty tough, especially near the end. And it's really like the last few stages can be very, very tough. I have beaten it, but it was tough like a giant cheeseburger, that's for sure. And like of course like they're not set in like areas in the rescue mission. They're set up in like stages. There's 14 stages overall. And they do have the fun factor to it, like 1 minute you're like just shooting away with your weapons, another part's a sniper rifle and stuff, and it is the first game of the Time Crisis franchise where you play the female character, and I consider Alicia the main protagonist because like her story reveals the true ending of what happened in Lucano and stuff like that afterwards. I'm not trying to spoil it there, but that's what it is there. I mean, and when you beat the game, instead of that, the title screen, the press start title screen changes where it shows her on the title screen. That shows there that she's the main protagonist, in my opinion. But that's just me, though. Sure, the Tigers Wikia doesn't say that, but in my opinion, she's the main protagonist for sure. And though this game is great in stuff overall, but now you're gonna get a couple of bads here. Aside from the rescue mission, the other extra modes are nothing really special. There's a bunch of like time trial stuff like that, like trying to like beat a high score. It's just like they're just not as fun as the rescue mission, which is like exclusive to this game, like I said. And the difficulty in the rescue mission is just like could be very challenging. You start at the beginning of the stage, like with the rich time crisis, after you lose like your lives, start like that. But these are just minor things that don't really fit the game for me at all. You're so, final thoughts here. If you like Time Crisis 2, you want something better than that?
No.
Pick up Time Crisis 3. It's definitely the best of the bunch. Now, I may have mentioned all those small complaints there, but this game is still fucking awesome. Now due to the complaints I have, I will not be taking any points off. Nope, no taking points off here. This game gets a fucking perfect 10 out of 10. It is the best game in the franchise and definitely worth owning in your collection there. Tiger Steve is definitely awesome news. And it's great because this game came out on my 15th birthday because it showed that like, it's like something, hey, Tony, pick it up. It's awesome. And I did pick it up, and it was great. And that's it for this episode of my Time Crisis Mastered series review. Stay tuned for episode 2, part 5 of 6. We're going to take a look at Time Crisis, Crisis Zone, which is a spin-off to Time Crisis. This game was first released in the arcade, like in the 90s, like that. And we get to get its own version on the PlayStation 2. How does it fare? Is it better than Time Crisis 3? Is it worse than Time Crisis 3? Get to find out, which all I gotta say. If you like what you see or subscribe, like the video, comment down below, and join my Discord group, TT Bird Gaming Static. I'm always looking for more people to join. Link is in the description below, so click on it when you can. Which all I gotta say, this is Tony. Peace out. Have a great day and see you all in my review of Time Crisis, Crisis Zone.